Hello everyone. Concerning these tips, the one keyword you should keep in mind is subtle. You do not want to overdo it unless you are going for a stylized look. Alright, so the first tip is film grain. I personally use Photoshop, but you can also do it in Blender. You go to Compositing, you pull up a new window so we can see what's going on. You switch to Image Editor. And then by default, it should be pointing to your render result. Otherwise, you can go to this menu and select render result. Shift A will search for a mix node. We'll switch the type to overlay. We will search for a texture node. Plug the color into the second input, and then in texture, you're going to add a new texture. Type is going to be noise. We'll plug our image output into the first input of the overlay node, and then image into image. And here in texture, you're going to select the new texture you just created, which is also called texture because we didn't change the name here. All right, this is too much. You can change it using the factor. So a good value usually that I find is 0.1 or 0.2. As you can see, it's barely visible, but it gives an interesting look. For the second tip, I decided to switch scenes to show you the difference a little more, because the glare node is more prominent when we have specular or shiny elements in the scene, like this. What this node does is it can help add glow to bright areas of your scene, making them look a little more realistic and visually interesting. Again, we go to Compositing, Shift A, search for glare. For type, the one that works 90% of the time is fog glow. It's usually the best one. And for the quality, you always go with high. So usually the only parameter you want to play with is the mix. A value of 0 in mix means 50-50 between the processed image and the original image. So you usually want to tune this down until you are satisfied with the result. Free zoom in. We can see the difference by muting the glare node with M. The last node we will be using is lens distortion, which is my favorite. So lens distortion can help simulate the way that light bends as it passes through a camera lens. This can make your renders look more like real photographs. It can also help draw the viewer's eye towards the center of the frame. So the way we add it is, of course, Shift A, search for lens distortion. Usually you want to check the fit option to avoid having lens distortion on the contour of your image. So the two golden values are usually 0.01 and 0.02. So you want to play in this range to have something to until you find something you like, but usually this is a really good value. So if we zoom in, we can see that the effect is very subtle. We can also see that the colors are starting to separate on the logo here, the RGB channels. So it might not seem like much, but trust me, it really makes a big difference, and the viewers, I will probably notice it. That's it for me. I hope these tips can help you create more visually compelling renders. If you have any questions, make sure to ask me in the comments. Have a great day.